Hello everyone, this is Brian from FinancialTradingJournal.com and this is episode 8 of my How I Trade Binary Options series, and in this video I'll be covering the stochastic oscillator. So, just an introduction again, just to remind you guys of how things work here. Episode 5 and 6 is the backbone, right, of my trading. I show you how to set up my charts and my newbie strategy. That's always in the background. Then every episode onwards relies on that. Episode 7, I did fib lines for retracement levels, so you can use that for retracing pullbacks and all that stuff. Now, the next thing I'll be talking about here in this episode is the stochastic oscillator, which also aids you in finding where the trend is going to be pulling back or reversing or continuing the trend, you know. So these things are kind of used at this either together or separately. It's up to you, see what works, you know. But basically what I gathered from Dog's thread on HSM was KISS, which is keep it simple stupid. Okay, don't overcomplicate things. You don't want to be confused when you're trading. You never want to turn on your charts and you're like, what the hell am I looking at? You never want that mentality. Especially not after you set up your chart, because that would be really embarrassing if you're looking at your chart and like, I don't really know how to comprehend what I just drew. So that would be really stupid. You don't want to overcomplicate to that point, because sometimes when you go through forums on like, especially Forex forums, and pros post their charts and they have like lines going all over the place, and they have different MAs, they have like 300 different lines on their charts, and you're like, how do you decipher that? You know, you shouldn't really take time to decipher your chart. You should keep it simple so that you look at your chart like, oh, I understand what's going on. I know where to place my trade. That's it. Simple. Keep it simple. Simple and easy to use. Use what works for you, okay? That's what I emphasize in all my videos. So a little background info before we start. This was developed by Dr. George Lane, and he had a MD, not a PhD. He's not a postdoctorate. He's a doctorate in medicine. So kind of awkward, kind of like me. I'm a biologist learning economics and going into finance. So you can come from any field and you'll do fine. So if a doctor can do this, you can do this too. So basically there are three modes of this. There's the fast, slow, and full modes, and each mode is determined by the settings of the user. Personally, I don't care how it's calculated. Like, I don't give a shit. Like, you can show me all the formulas, but I really, at this point in time, I don't care. All I care about if it's functional for my strategy or not. If I can use it, then great. Otherwise, keep that to yourself. Like, if you want to find out exactly how to calculate these things, then I suggest you Google it and find out how the formulas work, what they use, what variables and all that stuff, then great. And if you can use that to manipulate the variables to your advantage, then great again, but that's entirely up to you. So the stochastic oscillator is basically a momentum indicator, aka MOMO. That's what the stock traders use. The terminology for momentum is MOMO, and that's what I used to use a lot when I traded stocks back in 2010. So according to Dr. Lane, momentum changes direction before price. That's what he said, direct quote from him. So using this, you can use this tool to help you to spot potential trend reversals coming up. So here are my settings. I use period 14, and for percent K is 3 and percent D is 3. These are the default settings for MT4. So depending on what charting platform, that may vary for you, but you can change the settings to match this 14, 3. That's what it looks like on the chart after you're done. And I'll show you how to add this indicator on both free stock charts and MT4 today. I'm going to slowly move into MT4 because that's my favorite charting platform. I don't really like using free stock charts that much. I don't know about you guys, but it lags my browser. And I don't really like that because I use my browser to trade, like to actually enter on the broker, whereas I use my charting platform, which is a desktop application, for the actual chart. So they're not intertwining. So I'm just gonna flip to that right now. So starting with free stock charts, I'll again, just since I normally start with this one, log in first, then all the settings come into play. Doesn't matter what time frame you use. Preferably for me, I use 5-minute chart, but it's up to you. Depending on your trading style, you can pick hourly chart, 15, 30 minute, 1 minute, up to you. It's open-ended. All of these strategies are always open-ended. They're not like systems, which require you to follow me step by step. Strategies are you use whatever you like, and you adapt it to your own trading style. That's what I emphasize in all my videos. You customize to your liking, not mine. I don't care how you trade. As long as it works for you, then do it. So, click add an indicator, and we're going to add the stochastic. So, as you saw, there are multiple stochastics. There's a stochastic RSI and the regular one. I'm adding the regular one. And these are the default settings for free stock charts. So, you only have to change them. So, you click left click edit. Now, the period is 14. Percent K is already right at 3, and change this one to 3, and that's it. It's gonna paint the green line here at the 80 and the brown line here at the 20. That's for overbought and oversold areas. That's by default, it's just gonna do that. So this is how you add it on free stock charts. Now I'll show you how to add it on MT4. So this is what MT4 looks like for those of you that have never seen it before. In the top, you'll notice that's the broker that I use, and MetaTrader Euro USD 5-minute chart. It's also right here. If you notice in any of my MT4 charts, rather than having the symbol in the background like it does on free stock charts, it's shown on the top left corner. And also shown on these tabs, but I don't think I take those in my picture. So anyways, for the indicators, if you have it set like this, the navigator is on the bottom left, looking for stochastic oscillator. Left click, drag it onto the chart that you want, and then you set the parameter. See, this is the default 14.33, and blue-red is for the lines, and then the automatic levels are at 20 and 80. That's what it looks like, which is exactly the same as what free stock charts looks like. So this is what MT4 looks like on Euro USD 5-minute chart, and market's already pre-market opening. If you're wondering what this is, it's only 3 p.m. right now on Sunday, but OANA has pre-market, and this is what free stock charts has. So back to my PowerPoint. So here's the strategy. You can think of the percent K blue, which is the blue line in the MT4, as similar to the 13 EMA in episode 6. And you can think of the percent D, the red line, as the 20 SMA in episode 6. Episode 6, I covered my newbie strategy and how I used EMA and SMA crossings for determining trend formations. You can use the same analogy here. When it crosses up, then it's going to reverse trend up. If it crosses down, it's going to reverse trend down. So it's the same mentality, same crossing. It's just used on a different indicator. But in addition to when they cross, you care about where they cross. Because this is an indicator. It has its own indicator window. It's not on your actual chart. So you care about the levels, which I just mentioned briefly before. You have the 20, which is the oversold. And you have the 80, which is the overbought. Now, for those of you that trade stocks, you may have seen this because most stock charts have the RSI, which is the relative strength index. So that's where these numbers, most of these indices or indicators have the levels at. So typically you want it to cross down when it's in the overbought regions and to cross up when it's in the oversold regions. And now for me, it doesn't really matter where it crosses. Some people are picky, you know, you need to cross exactly when it gets below the 80, then it crosses, and that's stronger than crossing while it's above the 80 or at the 80 or below the 80. You know, some people get really technical about where it crosses and the angle of crossing and all that stuff. It's up to you. You watch it on your chart and you see how you like it, then you use it if it works for you. It doesn't always work for me, that's why I don't really like leaving it on the chart. It takes up space, so I like to look at the whole chart rather than having some indicator block it. some precautions before we use this, and I go through examples. They can be used on any time frame, but be careful. Like, for example, if you use it on the 1 minute time chart, then it might be subjected to a lot of price swings. You'll notice the oscillator going up and down like crazy, because it's a 1 minute chart. You're going to have swings all the time, so you're going to swing up and down, up and down, up and down, up and down. That may be used for 60 second options, but that's entirely up to you again. For the 5 minute chart, a place to be careful is if it's say a downtrend, and then the oscillator is going to cross up for a pullback. Now, this could be a fake cross. It could be either a fake reversal, or it could just be a pullback. So you need to use your PA to see what's going to happen or what you think is going to happen. Or you can also use it for continuation of the trend. So let's say it pulled back. Now it's going to continue the downtrend, so it's going to cross down. So you could be looking for those, for continuation rather than reversals. It's entirely up to you. Combine it with your PA and use it to your liking. But it's usually best used for the higher time frames, like the 1 hour chart or 2 hour or 4 hour charts, because then you can tell by it's an actual reversal, because it's going to hover down in the oversold regions, then it's going to start spiking up, and that's where the reversal starts coming in. So again, it's up to you. And ranging markets is another place you could use it, because it's going to go up and down in a channel. And after you draw your channel lines, your support resistance lines across the chart, then you're going to look at the oscillator and you're going to be like, it's approaching the bottom line, so it should cross up soon. So if it crosses up, then you know it's going to start bouncing. If it keeps going down, then it might break the channel and it breaks out instead of ranging. You know, it depends. It's up to you, entirely up to you. I don't know exactly how many examples I have. I forgot. So here's the first chart. This is, like I mentioned earlier, the MT4 chart, so you can see the pair and the time frame in the top left. As for the dates, they're at the bottom here. So if you want to know exactly what pair I'm using, just pause the video and just, as soon as I load the chart, pause the video, look at the top left, and then continue going, and you'll know what chart I'm using. It's not like free stock charts, which is in the background. So just take note of that for those of you that care for what pair I'm using. So I'm doing this in paint again just to show, just to draw things easier. Let's see now. So you can, and these are historical charts from August. They're not, because I don't want to use the January data that we have right now or December from last month, because holiday trading is different from during good times like August. That's why I use these good data days or the good charts from the past. So you can tell there's a slight range there that lasts from... this is the 5 minute chart, so this is... that doesn't make sense. So this is a weekend, so I'm assuming that's Sunday. Sunday from 3, which, so this is actually pre-market, so it's not that great either. But anyways, just to illustrate the point, this is a range. So you see bounce, 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 bounce inside this range. So it goes up, then down, then up, then down, then up, then down, then breaks, and then breaks. Right? So now you look at this bounce happened here at this point. It trends back downwards. Then here, it goes back, it crosses back up. Here crosses down, here it crosses up, here it crosses down, here it crosses up, here there is no cross yet. It breaks out and then it crosses here, but you're already outside the channel, so this is forming an upward channel. So that's how you use it for ranges. You know, it's kind of lagging from time to time, sometimes it's leading. You know, you use it to your strategy, to however you like. This chart doesn't have my newbie strategy on it. It has something else, which will be explained in episode 10. So let's see now. This is an upward channel, right? Chart's getting messy with all the drawings now, but you can tell in the upward channel from here to about here, that's the whole upward channel. So for pullbacks, you know, you can see here there's a pullback which starts to happen, let's say here or here with the pin bar. pin bar, pull back, and it lasts until here, at which point this crosses up for continuation of the trend. So you can trade two ways. You can trade the pullback for a reversal, or you can trade the continuation of the trend. It's entirely up to you. Use what works. This is Australian, I mean the Euro USD 5 minute. And let's see now, we have downtrend, reversal. So here, if you're drawing it up like that, this crosses at the red candle, which is after it closes. So this is the problem with backtesting. I don't like using backtesting because of this bullshit here. This, don't be misled that this green happened after the red. Yes, it did happen after the red, but upon closing this red candle, this crossed. Then the next one, it's already crossing. So now you choose whether to enter or not, but you wait for confirmation. So you enter at this one, which is already deep inside the cross. So then you have to decide when to enter and all this stuff. So I don't really use the stochastic oscillator as a leading indicator. I don't use it as a, like, I don't use it to make my decisions. I use it to confirm my decisions when I'm trading. Okay? So let's say you're using the newbie strategy. You're waiting for the cross, which is a lagging indicator, by the way. So you're using, say you start with PA. PA says it's going to reverse up here. Then your EMA is going to cross sometime soon. Then your stochastic is going to cross to. So you're using these as confirmation tools, not really telling you what to do, but rather confirmation. So I'm sorry for those of you that are looking for one signal, how to trade this, how to trade that. I don't really use those. I use my own judgment and PA to trade. I don't bother with systems telling me what to do, because markets are dynamic. So this is overall bad area. So let's use this. This is a trend. You can tell trend there, pullbacks there, and support levels are drawn like that. And you see pullback here starts getting choppy. Then for let's see, what's a good bounce? Bounce would be here. So it bounces off your trend line. This is what the red line, the red off the trend line that I drew, it bounces off, which is before this thing crosses. This next bar here, it'll already bounce off your PA. So if you're trading trend line, you would put your put there. But then here, if you're waiting for confirmation, it crosses there. And the next one would be really close to the end, so you wouldn't really place a trade there, because that's already, it already crossed at that point. So, you know, different ways to use it, just use it to your liking. I'm not going to do too many examples on this indicator because I don't really like it. So here's another range. This is USD CAD 5 minute. Let's see, that's trend line like that and trend line like that. So let's, so you would wait to form the trend line after this area. So up to there is what you need to form your trend line. So playing it, this is your first bounce. So trading down, pointing down, you would have a bounce on that red. You would enter your call there if you're trading the trend line. It's about to cross on the green, so it crosses. Then you would trade it. So this is, again, confirmation, basically. And it starts getting up to here, which is near the upper trend line. Then it's about to cross again. You play the put there, and it bounces, and it crosses, just so you're good. Here, it's not all the way down, so I wouldn't trade it. Here is starting to break out of it, but anyways, that's still trend line. And that's about to cross again. That's about to cross up, trying to break out. It doesn't. It forms that pin bar there, and then you're trading it back down. So you're using it, it's lagging, it's a confirmation indicator. It's not a leading indicator, so just keep that in mind when you're using stochastic. Example number four. What do we want to use here? We can use these bounces. And this is the descending triangle from the pattern formation video. So you would wait for this point and that point. So this would form your support. We're going to look at this. And we're going to look at this area. So let's say this is a pullback. And because the line is formed from these candles and the line are formed from these candles. So here is the first touch. It's going, you play a put if you want. It's going to start crossing there. Then for the next somewhat like four candles, it doesn't really start reversing until here, but you would win anyways. It's lower till there. So that's crossing confirmation that's forming, and it forms this downtrend for the whole next while. And then here it starts getting choppy. That's why here's when you stop using it, because it's choppy. Use your PA. So in this downtrend here, you wouldn't bother using stochastic because it's going to get choppy. You're going to like, you know, screw this stochastic. Just pay attention to the PA, and then it works for you. Here it's starting to approach, but I wouldn't trade that anyways. If you want to go a mini trend line like that, you could do that as well. And then you would trade this area. But I'm going to focus on this bounce here. So this is a support bounce right there. Trade the call. That's a high probability trade right at the edge there. It touches it. You need to be really fast here. And that's a pin bar. That's a pin bar also. And so it's about to cross. Next bar is green. It crosses. Then you get this choppy nature again. It crosses back down. So you're like, is it going to break support or not? It doesn't. Green bar forms. It starts reversing and you're good. And you trade that. This is September 14th Euro USD, and let's use these, the trend line play here, formed by those. Technically you draw them, they'd be drawn like that, but anyways, there's that, which is there, forms near the time of crossing. So this is why PA is so much better. You just use PA. And you use this stochastic if you're antsy or scared. Don't really want to use that word, but you know, you use this to kind of reassure yourself that it's a good trade in the right direction, you know. So yeah. So then here's another one. But the thing you have to be careful with is the timing. See this drop here. So you're looking from the cross up to the next cross. That's a period of 4 or 5 bars. So, you know, it's not a long period. And depending on your entry, you may or may not lose in the money or out of the money. So that's, again, how you use it. But it's entirely up to you. That's it for my examples. There's only 5 examples. I don't really need to go into detail. This is like the fib lines. It's just, if this happens, you look at the cross, look at the balance points, and then that's it. And you notice I didn't pay attention to these lines. This is the 80 line and this is the 20 line, overbought and oversold. I didn't really bother with that. But if you notice something like, if you notice like these bounces here, they still bounce. This is a mini channel there, you know, and they still bounce, right? But they may not be as good, but it's up to you. You use them however you like. It doesn't matter to me. Technically, these levels there are just there for visual appearance. So, final notes, recommended brokers are TradeRush for 60-second options, 24 options for everything else. I have links to them below in the description. I have my blog link in my Twitter feed. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. I'll see you guys next time for episode 9, which may or may not come out tonight.